Hi, I'm Karen McKee, and welcome to my channel on scientific writing. Today I'm going to be talking about the use of first-person pronouns in scientific papers. Should you use them? If so, when do you use them, and what do you do if your target journal rejects your paper because you use first-person pronouns, which is what happened recently to one of my colleagues? What are first-person pronouns? These are pronouns we use to refer to ourselves when reporting our research. I, we, me, my, our. We hypothesized that sedimentation patterns during storm surge would be influenced by vegetation type and structure. Scientists and academic writers in general have historically avoided first-person pronouns because it was thought to suggest bias or arrogance on the part of the authors. Although use of first person has been frowned upon for generations of researchers, its use has increased in recent decades. More journals are allowing first person pronouns in an effort to improve readability of papers. First person pronouns are most often used when stating an opinion or describing a personal action or observation. For example, the first sentence in Watson and Crick's 1953 paper in Nature. We wish to suggest a structure for the salt of deoxyribose nucleic acid. They also use the phrases, in our opinion, we believe, and we have assumed. Today, it's not unusual to see statements such as, here we report the results of a 5-year study. We conclude, based on our experiment, that species A is a better competitor for nitrogen than species B. Unlike previous investigations, we acclimated the plants to growing conditions prior to treatment. The APA-style guidelines encourage use of first-person pronouns in scientific writing and remind authors to use the pronoun I to refer to themselves and to use we with co-authors. The guidelines specifically warn against using third person, such as the author, because it can introduce ambiguity about who performed the action. First person is most commonly used in the abstract, introduction, discussion, and conclusion sections. Third person and passive sentence structures are typically used in the methods and results sections. The use of first-person pronouns can sometimes help improve readability. For example, consider this passive construction. To better understand the effects of sea level rise on coastal marshes, changes in soil elevation, sediment accretion, and land subsidence were examined. This type of sentence is difficult for the reader to grasp. If we rewrite it using first-person, it's easier to comprehend. We examine changes in soil elevation, sediment accretion, and land subsidence to better understand the effects of sea level rise on coastal marshes. First-person pronouns can also improve clarity. For example, the field study by Williams et al. Found that seed predation was important in determining spatial distribution of tree species, whereas Miller and Andrews could find no relationship. The authors confirm the latter finding. This is ambiguous as to which authors are being referred to. If we change the last sentence to, we confirm the latter finding, it's now clear who is confirming the finding of Miller and Andrews. First person can also be used to establish your perspective when discussing the literature. I agree with Brown et al. That a stratified random design should be used to establish experimental plots across the intertidal zone. Before submitting your paper, it's always a good idea to check with the journal author guidelines or scan some papers in the journal to determine if and how first-person pronouns are used. Some journals, however, adamantly prohibit use of first-person pronouns, as a colleague of mine found out the hard way. He submitted a paper to a respected journal in his field. It was a critique of how a crop biomass sampling tool had been used incorrectly by researchers, including himself. In the paper, He told a story about his experiences and naturally included a lot of opinions and suggestions for improvement. The journal rejected his paper because he used first-person pronouns to refer to himself. Only after he reluctantly replaced I with the author did the journal accept his paper for publication. As you might guess, this change led to some awkward phrasing. Here's an excerpt from the paper that illustrates this point. Pause the video to read. The paper continues in this vein with the term the author used a total of 31 times. This is perhaps an extreme case in which strict avoidance of first-person pronouns led to a clumsy narrative. However, it prompted my colleague to write an opinion paper regarding use of first-person pronouns, which goes into greater detail about why scientific authors should use them. Specifically, that use of first-person pronouns can help make our papers more engaging and interesting to readers. And as I pointed out earlier, first-person usage can improve readability and clarity and emphasize the author's perspective. However, there are instances in which first-person should be avoided. For example, when it's important to convey objectivity. We demonstrated in a manipulative field experiment that nurse plants ameliorate harsh soil conditions, thereby promoting survival and growth of mangrove seedlings. It's not necessarily wrong to say this, but if it's important to avoid any appearance of bias, then you might state only what the outcome of the experiment was, as in the second version. In a manipulative field experiment, nurse plants ameliorated harsh soil conditions and promoted survival and growth of mangrove seedlings. It's also unnecessary to say, I think, in a paper, because any uncited statement made in a paper is taken to be the author's thought. Another consideration is that first-person pronouns can unnecessarily divert attention from the research and onto the researchers. Consider this sentence, which is active voice without first-person pronouns. In a long-term greenhouse study, elevated atmospheric concentrations of CO2 promoted the growth of mangrove seedlings. In this sentence, the emphasis is on what happened in a greenhouse experiment. If we insert a first-person pronoun, the focus shifts from the research outcome to the action of the researchers. We showed in a long-term greenhouse study that elevated atmospheric concentrations of CO2 promote the growth of mangrove seedlings. Which version you choose depends on what message you intend to convey. In conclusion, don't avoid first-person pronouns, but use them sparingly, such as in instances in which you are expressing an opinion or explaining a personal action. Thanks for watching, and please hit the like button if you found this information helpful.